They ain't still ring bells in school anymore. I don't know.
No.
Probably not.
They probably get in trouble if they
don't. I'd like to say good evening to everybody.
Good evening.
Good to have y'all in the house of the Lord tonight. I believe if we turn loose and let the Lord have his way, we can get blessed. I'd like to open up with prayer. Thank you. Prayer request at this time.
Still remember our man.
Okay.
Don't get Frank and Andy. Keep praying for Terry's leg.
Yeah. And I will continue to pray for Brother and Sister Johnson down Florida. He called me today and Linda don't mind if I like me standing for Sister Johnson. She is diabetic. She's having a real bad trouble with one of her feet. And should we be praying for her? He keeps saying, he asked me again exactly how to get here, and he said, that's the same church. I said, I told him that was the church, and he passed it the other day. He said, I'm going to get up there and meet y'all one day, so pray that he make it one day.
Amen.
I remember my family, remember
He told me yesterday when he was at the house, and he thought it was getting too hot, but they think now he's got a kidney stone. He's hurting and everything, and passing blood, so y'all will be in much prayer for him. And you know, anybody's ever had one of them things, I tell you, they're very painful. I had one, praise the Lord, hope I don't ever get one.
Amen.
Might y'all continue to pray for me and my family?
Okay.
My sister Betty told me to tell everybody she appreciated all your prayers. And she's getting better. I came by to see her for a while, so getting better every day.
Continue to pray for our children and grandchildren, my nieces and nephews. We've been a couple of three times now, and I'm looking for God to bring on back.
Amen.
All we do is pray and give it to him. Let him take care of it.
And I also remember Eric, he's going more about that job and whatever the Lord wants him to be.
Amen.
Pray for Mike. He's had a little problem with the house being so hot and freezing and all.
Okay. Can you pray for this country? Our leader. Pray for the peace of Israel.
Amen.
Pray for our first responders. And they need our prayers. And this time of year, it's so hot that when y'all have to go out on a call, it's got to be worse than normal for y'all. It's got to be positive. Pray for everybody that's having to work outside in this heat. Pray for the services tonight. Keep our bodies
under that stuff. Do much prayer for Tammy Stabler and Michael Stabler and the family. I seen Jerry the other day at Big Wiggly, and he said pray for a cousin of theirs. I think he called him Gerald Tubble.
Yeah, he was in a bad
wreck. You heard any more from him and everything? But he said he'll be praying for him and everything.
So did y'all heard anything else from we don't want him to have a wreck. He said he won't be in the hospital.
Okay.
You know. One that one day got killed in there, right?
No, he got out.
He's out in the hospital now?
Okay. And he was out for the funeral and everything.
Oh, okay.
Brother Herman, y'all be remember my oldest daughter, Tammy. They're going to be leaving the whole family, going to, where is it at? That's some kind of camp.
Baldwin County, down there somewhere down there.
Church.
7-0 or somewhere in that way.
Okay. Having a motion. Any unspoken by lifting your hand? All right, come to the altar if you will, and let's all pray you have a stand, but let's take these needs to God. He wants to meet you tonight.
Father, we come before you here this night, we thank you for your grace and for your mercy. Lord, we ask God that you move in this service in a mighty way, God. Lord, your will be done here tonight by ours, God. Lord, you heard all these requests been made known, those sick in their body, those that, Lord, need a miracle, God. And Lord, you just move in a mighty way. We're going to give you praise and honor and glory, God. Stir the people's heart, God. Help us, Lord, to be drawn closer to you, Lord. Anoint the singing, anoint the preaching, God, the testimony that we give, God. Let everything be done for your glory, God. For you are merciful and you are loving, God. And we praise your holy name, Jesus. Just move in a mighty way, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
50.
When it is.
Thank you.
right now. How about that trouble in the truck?
Some of these days I know
praise him with all my heart, and I thank him for being able to be here tonight where I can praise him. And I just, I'm still believing God to do a work in my car. As I told Brother Dale, me and Gail went down there yesterday, and Brother Larry, we three laid hands on the car, you know, and believed God to touch it. And I was able to get in and drive it, and that felt good for the first time in over 2 months. But it's still doing that bubbling. But me and him said we'd just give it another day or two, you know, and see if it will, that stuff will seep down in there and feel it. But I know God can do it, because Megan reminded me today of years back when my son was getting ready to go to the youth meeting because he was going to speak that night. And my old van, it wouldn't crank. And my husband said there's no way that it was going to crank. It was something that was wrong with it. But anyway, my son had the faith to believe, lay hands on it, because he said, Mom, I was looking at you through the window, and he said, things is always happening and disheartening you. And he said, I knew we had to make it to church tonight. And he laid hands on the van and it cranked right up. And my husband just couldn't hardly believe, you know. But I know I've seen God do these things. And I don't know why it's taking so long this time. But God's got a reason, you know, for everything that happens in our life. And that's wants us to praise him. And I'm getting to the place that that's all I know how to do. I just keep praising God. And y'all pray for me that my faith will get stronger and I will stay close to God.
Amen.
Bless the Lord. Please, somebody else.
John, I love the Lord tonight. Thank you, God. Just thanking, you know, for another opportunity to be back in the house. And you know, I'm so thankful that I see y'all here. Y'all don't realize what a blessing y'all are.
Come on.
Amen. That is right.
And you know, I just thank God that y'all are back here. And I missed y'all. I have not got in touch with y'all. My car's been in shop. Lois's been in shop. I mean, you know, it's been one thing right after another. But you know, I do. I thank God for seeing y'all back in here and, you know, for all the blessings. Y'all just pray for me.
We appreciate that. Before Herman starts to sing, I want to tell you about something that last night, Betty had already went to bed and I went to bed. I couldn't sleep. And I was laying there just thinking and praying.
Come on.
And the Lord was showing me some things that needs to happen here. You know, and I'm thinking, well, what if we were to come in that door, and when we close that door behind us, we leave all the confusion and the strife and the things that hinders us out there.
Amen.
What if we come in here and use these altars that's on both sides of me for what they were built for?
Amen.
It's for us.
Come
it's
on,
not for somebody going down the road that's having to stop by here. It needs to get saved because God's drawing, and that's a good thing. Don't get me wrong.
Yes.
Amen.
That's what God for us.
Come on.
Pray today for us to come up here and pray.
Yes.
Yes. Amen.
The Word of God says that His house will be called a house of prayer.
Yes.
That's for a reason. You know? And something else that He showed me, when you come in here, put God first. Yeah. And let Him take care of all the rest of the stuff.
Amen.
Come on, John.
You know? And there's some other things that I can't say right now, but maybe they'll come.
Bless my brother, Lord.
I don't want to tell you right now, but they'll come.
Yes. Bless
God. I believe God will work on them.
Yes.
And I believe some of these things will help. I believe that if these things don't happen, the church won't prosper.
Amen.
I think it's holding us back.
Come on.
You know, I remember Brother Cobb said, grab on hold to the horns of the altar.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And just hang on. And I thought, you know, that horn sticking up there, you grab a hook to it, it'll help you to hold on.
Yes, it
will.
It'll help you to get where you need to be.
Come on. That's what we got to have.
You know, and another thing he has showed me that is about the love in your heart. If it's not there, she ain't going to make it.
Amen.
It's just that simple. And it's hard to tell you that, but I got to.
Amen.
If you don't feel like you got it in your heart, please come up here to the altar and get it there.
Yeah.
Because God bless you.
Yes.
Amen. Blessing God.
Bless you, brother. Thank you for obeying the Lord there.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, I praise you right
now. You know everything you said is true.
Amen.
Lord, in your name right now.
You got to put Him first. There's no doubt about it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
alright. Satan whispered, he'll make me slip forever someday. Oh, but it's not that easy, for there's a cross hanging in my way.
The cross, it stands between me and forever.
Dying sin is a choice left up to me. Sister Betty, I've said it many a time, I'm just ready to give up. And I recall the words of that song up there. All of our flesh gets weak sometimes.
Yes.
And we feel like there's no hope, Brother Betty.
Yeah.
But let me tell you something. What Jesus Christ done on that cross that stands in our way tonight.
Amen.
That's the thing that bridges us up to heaven and keeps that closed between us and hell.
Yes.
I can't tell you no more than what he done on the cross, because that's all you need to know.
That's all you need to know.
It's what he has done for you.
Yes.
And we need that. If you'll stop and think about what Brother Johnny Lowry said just a few minutes ago, if you'll stop and think about what Jesus Christ done on that cross for you, that was that love he was talking about. We've got to have that love in our heart for another tonight. And if you truly love God, then you'll truly love your brothers and sisters.
Amen.
Amen. And I just want y'all to continue to pray for us that we'll do what God has called us to do. And wherever it might be, whether it be here, Linda, or Kalamazoo, Michigan. I don't know how that name comes to my mind. It just hit.
Or the cold place.
Because that's what the old timer used to say, from here to Kalamazoo. I didn't even know back then where it was at. But it shouldn't matter tonight. If he calls you to go there, you should go. And I love him tonight. I praise him with all my heart. I just want to share one more thing with you. I'll try to hush and get out of the way with everybody. I was telling Linda today, I believe it was today, every time I see somebody selling watermelons on their truck,
come on,
I think about Usby.
Yeah.
Think about Bo Tollville.
Yeah.
And I can stand up here and call members of Sister Weldon and Sister Eileen. Yeah. We've had a lot to go home from this church. But you know what? No old boys ain't having to sit out there in the heat selling watermelons and stuff.
No.
I want to tell you something about Brother Gooby. I always called him Gooby. Gooby was going to come by our daughter's house most of the time twice a week, at least once a week, and made sure them youngins had plenty of fruit,
come on,
vegetables, whatever he had on that truck.
Yes, he would.
And he would never take a penny for it.
That's right.
I tried to pay him one time. I said, Gooby, let me just give you some money. You can't make it pay. He said, God takes care of me.
Amen.
If I can't leave nothing else to you tonight, God will take care of me. Amen. Y'all pray for us.
Amen. That he does.
Ooh, y'all was just trying to listen to that.
Lord, have
pray
tonight.
God, I want to do something this day.
Well, if there's somebody else likes to testify, they're going to sing.
Bless your God.
Bless your Lord.
Well, Johnny, I'm going to say I love the Lord tonight, and I thank you for everything.
Yes.
I mean, everything. I thank you for waking me up in the morning with a sound mind. Yes, sometimes I have aches and hurts in my body, but I still can go. You know, I thank God for that. And, you know, you look around, you see so many other people in worse shape than you are.
Right.
And some of them are children.
Yes.
You know, you see that it's down and going through all that they go through, and we've been blessed that we've made it this long, you know.
Amen.
And you know, talking about the love in your heart, yes. You're supposed to have love in your heart. Everybody is. You know, and I feel like, you know, that's what God is. He's love.
That's right.
And you know, I just thank him for that love because he shows it to me every day. Every day.
Amen.
And I have been going. Before my mother died, I'd been going through a battle nobody knew about. I don't even think Dale really understood. I didn't understand myself sometimes. But when I lost my mother, I didn't care if I got up, Toddy. I have to fight it to get out of bed now. I miss her so much. But I know God's going to bring me through. I know that he controls my mind and that he gives me peace of mind. You know, and I know she's not suffering anymore. But you know, the devil will play so hard on things like that. And I know I can't bring her back. I wouldn't want to bring her back. But I didn't realize the pain and the suffering that I can't even explain it. But I know God understands every bit of it. And you know, I was about to get out of the other battle, and this one hit me. I can't sleep at night sometimes, and I just lay there and just, I tell Dale, I said, pray that I can sleep, you know, because I ain't been able to sleep much. But I just love the Lord. You know, I'm going to be faithful to him because he's been faithful to me. He's brought my family, he's helped my family. Not only just for me, he's done many things for my family. You know, and you look around and you see all the people that are dying, and you know, we're not promised today, the rest of the day, or tomorrow. We never know when it's going to be our time. And that's why I realize, you know, I've heard it all my life, he's coming soon, he's coming soon. But I do believe he is fixing to return. And I believe if there's a time, you better get really close to him now, because I do believe he's fixing to return. And when that time comes, you know, people say, well, maybe I can pray right before he comes. But you can't do like that. You can't wait. You can't put it off. Because he's going to come in a blink of an eye.
That's right.
And there won't be no time then, be any time to say, well, Lord, forgive me for having a bad thought about this person. There'll be no time. And I just want to stay ready to go. So whenever he chooses to take me, I'll be ready and to just leave this old world.
Amen.
But y'all pray for me, because I do desire y'all's prayers. I need them every day.
You know, anybody that's lost a parent, it takes such an eye to them. They know that, but you'll never get back. And now both of mine is gone, but I was just thinking about one good thing that did happen when my mother passed away after that.
Come on.
It brought me and my sister closer together.
Amen.
We hadn't had a good relationship for a long time. Long time. And after that, it just helped us to get closer together. Mm-hmm. And I thank God for that. Anybody else like to testify? Come sing.
I love the Lord tonight, Johnny. Say that. Thank you for all that he's done for me.
Bless Sister Jewel, Lord.
And you know, he's going to be there with us no matter what we do.
Yeah,
that's right.
And so many of us have already lost our parents.
Amen.
And
come on, sir.
Maybe another loved one in our family, but you know, we promised to send his word and send a comforter.
Right.
And he does.
Amen.
He does send us that comforter. Where would we be without that comforter? You know, we could not make it through. We have to have him, you know, in our lives, you know, in order to be able to sustain the things that we go through, because he's promised us that peace that he gives us, you know. We can depend on that. We believe in his word tonight. We can depend on his word. But he is going to take care of us. He's going to see us. I love him and I thank him for all these things.
Bless you, Lord. Will it be somebody else?
Honey, I love the Lord tonight.
There's no life, Lord.
And you know, I depend on him 24/7. If it wasn't for him, I couldn't make it.
Amen.
I couldn't make it a little step.
That's right.
You know, he's got to be our everything. He's our strength and he's our source. And he is our comfort. But I understand where Charlotte's coming from.
Amen.
You wake up at 1 o'clock at night and you can't sleep. And you've never been attacked by the devil. Thoughts.
Come on.
Things in your mind. It's a praying time. And this one you have to get down and pray.
Amen.
You better be close to God to get through those battles, because they come. They come.
That's their God.
They assault you like you've never been assaulted. But I just thank God that he's always picked me up and he's always carried me through every one of them.
Amen.
And I'll just pray for me that he'll continue giving me the strength.
Yes.
That I can be what he wants me to be.
I would like to thank everybody that participated any kind of way with the help that me and Betty have received, whether it fit their prayers or money or a phone call, whatever it is. If you participated in it, I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Amen.
I hope God bless you for it. I know he will.
Yes, he will.
Anybody else like to testify, come sing?
Brother Johnny, I'd like to say I love the Lord.
That's ready to go.
I thank him also for everything he does in my life, because he's done a lot, you know. He's done stuff that I don't see.
Amen.
He's kept me time and time again. He brought me through situations like I said, nobody else has, you know. I thank him for my family. I thank him for the love that I feel for my church family.
Come on.
Amen. Listen.
Touch
me,
brother.
Lord.
Bless my brother.
Touch.
And we all, you know, the Bible says we're going to be tried.
Yeah.
If we're his people, we're going to be tried.
Come on.
We're going to face stuff that we don't understand. I go through stuff every day. Stuff goes through my mind every day. I don't understand. I can't comprehend. I can't grasp why it happens this way or why it happens that way.
Yeah.
I'm not supposed to. But what he always lays on my mind is Jeremiah 29:11.
Amen.
For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord.
Yes.
Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. So if I hold on to that verse.
Come on, brother.
And I know what he done at that cross for me.
Yeah.
And I trust and believe him.
Come on.
Yeah, them battles are going to come.
Yes, amen.
Them trials are going to come. Them situations are going to come that I don't understand. But that verse right there tells me he's going to give me an expected end if I hold on to it.
Yes.
God, amen.
And I'd just like to ask y'all continue to pray for me.
Yeah, bless you, God.
And you know, Brother Johnny, like Brother Gray said, we all go through it. We got to remember our Lord was tempted for 40 days when he was out there. He didn't fall to it, but yet he was tempted. But God sent the angels to minister to him, just like he does us. We people can say, oh, the devil don't attack me. He don't come against me. Oh, yes, he does.
Oh, yeah.
If you live in your life right, he attacks you. But we just have to give it to God.
But you know, on the other hand, And this thought come to mind, and God will give you an unction.
Yes, he will.
You know, if sometimes somebody's on your mind,
that's right.
They're there for a reason.
That's right.
You know, you're about to say them, pick up the phone and call.
That's right.
Like today after church, Stephen Cole texted me. He said, I'm just checking on you, how y'all doing. I just want to tell you I love you.
Right.
And that means a lot.
Yes, it does.
To somebody. Will it be somebody else that will testify or come saying?
Brother Johnny, I want to say I love the Lord tonight. Thank you for what he's done for me and my family, what he's going to do for us. And, you know, if it hadn't been for God, I wouldn't have made it.
Right.
You know, he brought me through things.
Come on.
And he brought me through a lot of stuff.
That's our God.
That I didn't think I could ever end it.
That's
amazing. He's right there with him.
Down here, my steps grow weary, and the road is rough and long. Sometimes I
messed up.
You
got it now?
That was on me. Still deep.
That was on me.
Ooh, I'm looking forward to that meeting.
Would it be somebody else like to testify, come sing?
Mother Johnny, I'd like to just say one more thing, mate. I'm so thankful that my cousin Doc Moore was here this morning.
Yes.
And you know, when he told Brother Dale what he told him at the end of the service, that was the kind of service that they used to have down at Little Rock at Victor Holden's church. They done turned into a community house down there now.
Yeah.
But you get a lot of members floating around.
Come on, brother.
Little church. And y'all just, y'all can be a place for him, but I don't want to see him in here.
Yes. Yes. Charlotte, you and Sheila come on up and have to sing the Lighthouse for Brother Terry. Yes, sir.
See.
Brother Herman was testifying about Brother Doc. Got one down the road, Jimmy, the one that works with Doc.
Uh-huh.
Has promised he's coming. And we're going to keep praying. They're going to be coming. God's going to bring them in. But we got to stand up right now and be that lighthouse. There's people, listen, there's so much stuff going on, they don't know which way to run. Their psychology and all the things that they're preaching from the pulpits nowadays is not working.
Amen.
And they're looking for somebody that's got the truth. Will you be able to stand up and point them to Jesus? Like the song says, there's a lighthouse there. There's a lighthouse on the inside. No blues like sea. When I'm lost, it seems that a light that I must see, and the light that shines darkness down, safely lead me.
And I
Hallelujah.
Lord, I praise you tonight, God, for victory. Praise you for victory.
Would it be anybody else like to testify or kind of thing?
I miss your opportunity now. God's been good to you.
Sure
have. You know, Brother John, I love the Lord.
Best brother, lead Lord.
Thank you, God. You know, just sitting here listening to everybody's testimony, the main thing that they said is love.
That's it.
They can preach on right there. Without love, you don't have nothing.
That's right.
And I thank God,
bless him, God. Bless
that my Father in heaven loves us so much that he put up his son's life.
That's right.
Yes.
Amen.
For each and every one of us.
Yes.
You know, it's like you said, Brother John, when you come in that door, leave your cares outside. Like he was saying in Sunday school this morning, come into his house for worship.
Yes, yes.
You know, the place is at. Then if you tell him what can go on or what our Lord has done, if we'll take the chains off and let him have his way, Lord, help me with this.
Come on, man.
Bless him, God.
It's time to quit praying church.
Amen.
It's time to quit. We've got loved ones that need to be brought in. People, if we don't open up our eyes and realize kids are dying left and right.
Amen.
When you have a 15-year-old and a 4-month-old lose their life the same night, what else is it going to take? I've got 2 girls sitting over there in that house. What's it going to take?
Come on. What's it going to take?
God is trying to tell us, people. He has spoke. That he's going to split them eastern skies. What else is it going to take? Are they going to have to come in here and shut these doors for us to worship our Lord? My brother has said things are moving fast.
That's right.
Faster than ever. You know,
Lee, we can make all the excuses that we want to make. But, you know, excuses, some kind of excuses is kind of like lies.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
Most of them all.
The Bible says all of us have that place in the lake of fire.
That's it.
So we're not fooling anybody but ourselves. You know, I heard Brother Cobb say it's going to take a good one to get there.
Yes.
And it is. I see it more and more. And we're running out of time.
We are. That's like me and Randall are talking. These old pioneers are just about gone. Mm-hmm. And like I said before, who's going to fill their shoes? Who's going to bring it for the young people like John, like all the other little ones that come in this church? Who's going to do it if we won't? You know, we've got to stick together. We can't just do one here, one there. We've got to be a unit. We got to put pulling apart we got to stick together and start showing more love.
And you know, it's a little saying, and listen carefully. If you always do what you've always done, you always get what you always got.
That's right.
That's right.
That's it.
Gotta be some change.
John Edwards, that is for you hands over the down. You know, you can think of love in a lot of different ways. But what is love? What is God's love?
Jesus.
What is it? What is his love? If you really sit and think about that, what is his love? You know, Dale had on the show, I think it was The Passion for Christ. I've never been able to watch it. He had it on there, and it was right at the part where they were beating him, and I couldn't watch it, and I had to turn it. Because that's the greatest love of all. He died for every one of us.
Amen.
And, you know, everybody's sitting in here, could you really say that you do that? I mean, could you really say that? Could you say that you'd actually think what he took for you? Now, that's love. You know. So, really, you could just really sit down and meditate by yourself on really what is love. You know. Not our love. His love. That's what it's going to take.
Would somebody else like to testify or come say?
I like to say I love the Lord. Thank
bless
him,
God. Come on.
More blessings than he gives me.
Bless him, God.
More blessings than I could ever say.
Bless him, Lord.
But I thank him for my wife, my new family. I thank him for the four boys that I have. And I ask that the Lord give us all strength to learn to be united in family, let him understand me.
I'm sitting back there. Was going to sing it, wasn't going to sing it. Was going to sing it, wasn't going to sing it. But I know the Lord wanted me to sing it, but the devil don't want me to sing it.
Come
so
on.
May not be for nobody else here, but it's for me.
Come on.
See, y'all pray for me.
Oh,
praise God.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Father, we praise you.
We praise you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, there is power in the name. Jesus.
He's a good thing, oh God.
Oh, hallelujah.
Oh, in the name of Jesus. We can reach in, God. There's no hope in here tonight.
Oh, yes, Jesus, Jesus.
Every chance.
Lord,
you have your way, speak to your children.
Thank you, Jesus. For yea, I say unto thee, thus saith the Lord thy God, yea, I say unto thee, my children, I am in thy midst this night, saith the Lord, to break those chains and set the captives free, saith the Lord thy God. And yea, I say unto thee, I would that my people would praise me, saith the Lord, that you would praise me through every valley and every trial, saith the Lord. For yea, I say unto thee, I'm a jealous God, saith the Lord. Yea, you are my creation, saith the Lord thy God, and I desire my people to lift up holy hands and praise me, saith the Lord. For too many of my people, as I've already said, are letting their minds wander here and there, saith the Lord thy God, and they're not giving me enough of their time, saith the Lord thy God. And you don't know how close it is, saith the Lord thy God. There will be no time then, saith the Lord thy God. Sing me while there is time, saith the Lord. Yea, I say unto thee, stay before me in prayer and stay in my word for the strength that I will give you, saith the Lord thy God. For my word and my strength is the only way. And yea, I say unto thee that Satan is going to and fro and deceiving all that he can, saith the Lord. But yea, I say unto you, my people know my voice, and a stranger they will not follow, saith the Lord thy God. Yea, I say unto thee now, my people, give me all the praise and give me all the glory. I am in thy midst. I desire to do a work in thee this night. I desire to touch thy bodies and heal thee, saith the Lord thy God. And I desire to lift thy burden, saith the Lord. Yea, give it unto me now, saith the Lord thy God.
Mm.
Ooh, hallelujah, Jesus.
Glory.
Ooh, hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus.
That's pretty plain, plain spoken, church.
Lord, we praise you, God. We praise you, God.
He's wanting to lift your burdens. He's wanting to heal your body. But he's a jealous God. We got to praise him. I just want to thank
thank you.
want you to praise him today. Come on, we don't praise him enough here today. I just want to thank you, Lord, for every time you heard my prayer. I just want to thank you for all the things he's always been. Stretch your hands this way. Father, we anoint Brother Freddie for Sister Rippy. God, you know what's going on in her life around her. Lord, you know the encouragement, God, that she needs to be lifted up right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, she's a soldier in the army, God. Lord, in your name right now, strengthen her, God. Lift her up in that word, God. Lord, keep her eyes upon you, Lord. God, the prayers that she's prayed for her children and grandchildren, Lord. I know you're faithful. And I know you heard them, God. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, God. Got your Bibles, turn with me to the book of Hebrews. Chapter number 11. Hebrews chapter number 11, verse number 1 and 2. The subtitle under my heading says, The Nature and Fruits of Faith. That first little word, three letters, is so important. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtain a good report. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Father, as I come before you right now and humbly as I know how, Lord, direct your servant in this word that I may preach it, God, the way that you give it. We're going to be careful to give you all the praise and all the glory, for we ask in Jesus' name. And the church said,
Amen.
Brother Freddie brought up something in his testimony to confirm where I'm to preach at tonight. We read this great chapter 11 of faith, and some have called it the Hall of Fame of faith. There are many names mentioned in the Bible that by faith they moved like God told them. But when you get towards the end of the chapter, the names are not mentioned. But listen what it says in verse number 33 down. It says, who through faith subdued kingdoms, wrought righteousness, obtained promises, stopped the mouth of lions, quenched the violence of fire, escaped the edge of the sword, out of wickedness, were made strong, waxed valiant in fight, turned to flight the armies of the aliens. Listen, women received their dead raised to life again, and here we are. And others were tortured, not accepting deliverance, that they might obtain a better resurrection. And others had trial of cruel mocking and scorning, yea, moreover, bonds, imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawed asunder, were tempted, were slain with the sword. They wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world was not worthy. They wandered in deserts and mountains and dens and caves on the earth. And these all, having obtained a good report through faith, received not the promise. God having provided some better things for us, that they without us should not be made perfect. Children, Brother Freddie said in his testimony, the Bible said we're going to be a tried people. What we're going through is nothing new. We like it when all of a sudden the heavens open up and answer just drops right out quickly.
Come on.
But more times than not, it doesn't happen that way.
Right.
Not that God cannot do it, but God in his wisdom knows what's best. And right now, Brother Fred, as you said, you can't understand why some of the things happen the way they do, why this does and that don't and everything. But we understand this, like you said, he knows his thoughts towards you.
Amen.
His finished plan is for you to walk down the streets of gold.
Amen.
Whatever it takes, church, I said this morning that gold tried in the fire, it has to be in the fire for it to be that sparkling gold ring or necklace or whatever you wear, because if not, it has impurities in it that will not let it shine. The hotter the fire, the truer the gold. Here it said right here, the world was not worthy of these that were tortured, mocked, stoned. When it talked about putting those sheep clothes and those goat skin, it was talking about they were sewed up and then wild animals were turned loose on them to devour them. Fred, it was a very unpleasant death. But they held on by faith, believing for the promise of what was coming. Now, I've got to preach to us here tonight a message of faith. But faith, though it be a mustard seed, faith must grow.
Amen.
Faith must grow. And your word has said that mustard seed faith, Brother Fred, has said, when planted, it grows up to be a tree that the animals, the beasts can get out of, the birds can make a nest in it.
Right.
But it has to be planted.
That's right.
It has to be tested. You can say, as you read, James said, show me your faith without works, and I'll show you my faith by my works. In other words, he had faith, Brother Herman. He would get up and say, all right, I prayed over it. I'm not going to sit here in the muddy grub. I'm going to trust God, and I'm going to go forward.
Amen.
I heard a preacher say, just like about that ark, such a little we heard preaching. He said, had not Joshua and him had that ark on the shoulders of those priests, when they stepped in that Jordan River, it would not have opened.
That's right, amen.
But it was faith, Brother Freddie, that they had the presence of God, that God said, go forward. God didn't stop that thing 30 minutes before they got there. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
God did not stop that raging river 30 minutes before they got there. It did not stop until they raised their foot and set on. When they stepped on it instantly, it dried up.
Amen.
That's the way faith works. Now faith is the substance things hoped for. We're all here tonight and we all got problems. There's things just like when Janet Thomas, they got a new family coming together. And if any of y'all's ever been in the shoes where they're at when you're blending the two families, it's not always easy. But I will tell y'all this. Jesus will make the way for y'all.
Amen.
Y'all gonna have victory. Because y'all come together in Jesus, amen, and you allow him to have his way. I'm going to tell you, God will blend it together in ways that you don't know. Is there going to be a battle? Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. There's going to be a battle. But that's when you take the authority on the word of God and you have that faith and say, now, Lord, here it is. Our problem, the Holy Ghost said the other day, we don't turn loose of it. We give it to him. And then before he can do anything about it, we snatch it back. You see, how do we snatch it back? When you begin to speak words of doubt, when you begin to allow your thoughts and your mind to come around and begin to be bombarded by the enemy, and you begin to say things or do things that you know are not right, we've all been there. We've all been there. Come on, everybody. We've been there. Huh? Every one of us. When we get down in the battle, and it seems that we're losing, Brother Herman, it takes something to keep fighting. I thought about what they said about Wilson, I believe it was, the president. Said that he was in World War I. And he was a fellow that you looked at and you wouldn't consider him to be tough. You know, he was, you know, everything just wasn't that way. But anyhow, he was a captain of a small group of men. They were in World War I. And Brother Herman, the shells began to fall around him and everything. And all of a sudden, they began to jump up and run. And said he jumped up and hollered as loud as he could, where are y'all going? Get back up here and fight.
Amen.
They turned around. This mild-mannered man brought that group in. And they moved forward. And from that, he got moved on up in the rank. And he said that them men would follow him to the ends of the world. You know why, Johnny? Because they exhibited that faith that he had in them, that they could win the victory. They could win the victory in Jesus. But Brother Herman, we've got to have somebody that's going to stand up and say, where y'all running to?
Amen.
The Bible said, the Holy Ghost spoke here tonight, said you've been running 2 foot, here now. Running because of fear, y'all. Come on, everybody.
Amen. Blessing God.
You can't get no help if you don't get a knowledge that you need help. The Bible said you have an adversary, Satan.
That's right.
And said he goes about, sister, and as a roaring lion. In other words, you ain't got to figure out where he's at. He lets you know.
Yes, he does.
Amen. He will holler out to you. Fearful thing cause you to want to give up. But that's when you got to have the faith of God.
Amen.
And trust God. Amen. And believe God. Now faith is the evidence of things hoped for. The evidence of things not seen, Josh. How many got faith tonight that God's going to do what he said he's going to do for you?
Amen.
Yeah. Are you trusting God?
Amen.
Yes, are you God. Trusting God? Here tonight, our faith is measured by how you believe God, how you trust God. These names in this word right here in this chapter, Josh, they were no different than you. Noah was no different than you. Abraham, Jacob was no different than you. I'm going to tell you right now, they trusted God. They believed God. The judges, Barak, and different ones, they trusted God and said, God, if you said it, I'll do it. And they moved forward, Anna.
They put everything in God's hand. You think about David when he goes down to fight Goliath. Over 9 foot tall. Herman, God prepared him. Now I want y'all to understand something here tonight. It's a rough trial right where you're at right now. But God's been preparing you for this for a while. You look back over this thing. God's been preparing you. God never sent David out to fight Goliath without the lion and the bear.
That's right.
God never did that. God let him go through these things to show him, David, I can be here with you with the lion, I can be here with the bear. So that's why the Bible said that David made haste to fight the Goliath, the giant. Everybody thought, David, you're crazy. But they hadn't been where David had been. Nor has anybody been where you're at.
That's right. Amen.
And you've seen God. Every one of you here under the sound of my voice, you've been places with God. You've been into the impossible valley. You've been at that place where it seemed like there was no way out, Brother Herman.
Right. Amen.
You've been there with your back. You've been there with those years of nothing coming in.
Amen.
But was God faithful?
Yes, He was.
Amen.
Me and Johnny got a little thing together about them stents. That's a feeling, boy. And if you've been there, baby, you have one too, ain't you? When they go working on that old ticker, I don't know what it is. There's something about it changes you.
Yes, sir.
It changes you.
But Brother Herman, I can remember going by this church early that morning. It was still dark. And I can remember going over that overhead bridge down in Atlanta. And my mind was not on Mobile. It wasn't there. It was on that little old church I was going to go by. I said, Lord, we're going around this curve now. But I could picture it in my mind. I said, there's going to be a light out there.
Right.
And when I passed that light, this was my prayer. I said, God, if you're not through with me down there, bring me back. My hope. I had faith, Linda, that when I'd see that light, I'd know I'd be going by this church. And I cried out to God, I said, God, if you're not through with me, if you're not through with me, bring me back.
Amen.
And He was faithful.
Yes, He was.
He was faithful, Linda.
Yes,
that's been over 7 years ago.
Amen.
He was faithful to me and He brought me back, Brother Herman. I'm going to tell you, I've been in places just like y'all have where impossibility, Sister Lois, this thing with your car is nothing no different than some of this other stuff that God's brought you through.
Amen.
Just like with your son laying his hands on that automobile, the same God that touched that automobile is the same God that heard your prayer.
Yes.
Same God. Hallelujah. And I can go on and on, Sheila. You know, the times with Mike, when you had to stand, look death in the eye, tell the devil, no, you're not taking him until God saves him.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. That's now faith. That's stepping out right now and trusting God.
Amen.
Every one of us here have that faith because God said He put it in you. You got what you have need of. But our problem is, Stephen, we got to exercise it. Faith is never meant to be put up in a can and closed up. Faith is something we are to use every single day. I want to tell you something that helps me. I don't know if it helps y'all or not. But every time you get up in the morning, thank God that you're breathing.
Amen.
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 That's right.
Before I get out of bed, Freddie, I thank God for another day.
Amen.
When I lay down at night, Johnny, I thank Him for another night that I made it through. When I get up in the morning, I say, thank you, Lord, for another day. Does that mean it's always a good day? Oh, I have battles, but it's always a good day. Because the psalmist said, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in. I have a choice, Brother Freddie. I can rejoice no matter what comes or what goes. Why? Because I have hope not in this world only.
Come on.
My hope is in God, Freddie.
Amen.
And He's promised if I hold on to Him, He's going to hold on to me. That now faith, it said, by it they retained a good report. Friend, when I stand before the Lord, stand there, I want a good report. I want God to be able to say, my good and faithful servant, Freddie. I want Him to be able to say, He's done all that I told Him to do.
Amen.
What about you? Sometimes it's hard for us to understand balance in our lives. I remember Sister Linda, she don't mind me saying, there was a time she was going through a valley, been in the valley for a while. But she was faithful coming to church, faithful just trying to worship the Lord. But you could see the burden. Brother Herman, I was going by shaking hands as I usually do in the mornings. And she grabbed me by the hand. She said, "Preacher, how long is the valley? How long is the valley?" Some of you right here tonight, you're saying the same thing. How long is the valley? How long will it be before I hear God, see God? Preacher, I'm trusting God. Preacher, I'm leaning on God. But how long is it going to be before I feel something changing? And I had no answer. Because only God knows the length of that valley.
Amen.
Brother Herman, I can't tell somebody how long they'll be in a trial.
None of us can.
All I can tell you is that God will be faithful with you. He'll be there every step of the way. And He will not let you be overloaded. You may think you're overloaded. You may think, listen, God can't lie. He said He would not. He would not, Freddie. Now we think we are. But what is that? Just like you taught in that Bible lesson. It's to draw us to Christ. Freddie, that looks like a little course I sing. Sometimes it takes a mountain. You know what's so strange, Brother Herman? Sometimes we think we're really just right where God wants us. You know, we're really doing all we can for the Lord. But God said, there's another step up I want you to get.
Right, come on.
But see, we done gotten that routine. We're happy right where we're at. Man, we're getting blessed. And you know, and everything. We're not rocking the boat nowhere, so to speak. And we're just, everything's going by fine. But God said, there's another step.
Yes, sir.
I want you to get a little closer. But Brother Fred, to get a little closer. He's like, I got to get a little further down on my knees.
Mm-hmm.
A little more dedicated. And what causes that? The mountains. The troubled seas. Little desert places when it seems like you can't feel God. Come on. The Bible said, listen then. Moses then wandered in the wilderness needing water. And Moses, the Bible said one time he was told to smite the rock. He did, and water came out. The next time he was told to speak to the rock, but he got so aggravated with the people, he smote the rock, but God still gave the water. But it caused him not to be able to go into the promised land.
Right.
Amen. Brother Terry, Brother Paul brought it out, the Holy Ghost revealed to him, said that rock that followed them in the desert was Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Think about that. Hallelujah. That rock didn't just show up, Linda. It was there following them. God said they're going to need water, and I'm going to have this rock waiting for them to show them I can provide for them. You're right where you're at tonight, and you're saying, God, where's the rock? He's got it right there for you. Just get a hold of God and listen to what He said. Betty, I've listened to that song many times. You sing it and love it. But that second verse says, know His word. Know His word and obey. I mean, it just like went over a microphone. Know His word and obey. If you know this word, Brother Freddie, if we know this word, there's victory in this word right here. When you begin to know this word and obey this word and do what this word says, regardless what you feel, listen, the greatest battle you'll fight is with you.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. Hello? Come on. I said the greatest battle you'll fight is with you.
Amen.
Because the devil can't do nothing unless you allow him to.
Amen.
But I want to tell you something, Brother Freddie. We open the door wide sometimes.
Oh, no, we did.
We open the door wide sometimes and we allow the enemy to come in and he begins to set up shop in us and we begin to get angry. We begin to get hurt. We begin to get just feel like we're not worthy of this and just feel like somebody's done us wrong. And we know that that's not God's word. That'll never get us anywhere.
But I like what Brother Terry said. Praying about his feet. He said the doctors have said that don't get some circulation down them feet, Johnny. You didn't go back and pray for him by accident.
That's right.
God sent you back there. There ain't some movement in that feet, Betty. Doctor said he could lose his feet. But you know what he told me? He said the same El Shaddai that brought me, gave me breath, be the one who'll take me out, take care of me.
Amen.
That's what it's going to take.
Right,
it's going to take that walk with God. Say, God, I don't want to lose my feet. But God, if that's the way it's got to be, so be it. I still serve you. I still worship you. Now faith is the one when you walk to. Say, God, I know you're here.
Amen.
Regardless of what my body says, what people say around me, I know. Now faith. And listen to this third verse. We overlooked this, what it says. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God.
Right.
So that things which are seen were not made of things that do appear. If God could speak the world into existence, huh? If God could speak all this beauty we see, simply said, let there be. Johnny said it best one time, said, if God done it one time, you remember that, Johnny? If God done it one time, reckon he'll be able to do it again, ain't he? So if God spoke something into existence, young people, cannot he do it again? He said, as your faith is, so be it unto you. Brother Freddie, if I got large faith to believe large things, I'm going to receive large things. If I got little faith, receive little faith. Why? Because the Bible says this. We sow sparingly.
Reap sparingly.
We sow bountifully. Now, how many knows? Any of y'all ever done any gardening? That's a work of faith, then. You buy them seeds, Brother Herman. You buy that fertilizer. You get out to lay them rows on. But when it comes down to it, when you lay that seed in, it's a work of faith.
Yes, sir.
Because you don't know where they're coming up or not. Have you ever planted anything and didn't come up?
Oh, yeah.
Come on. It's a work of faith, but if you sow sparingly, you say, now, last year these tomatoes just, or these peas just didn't work good. I don't think I'm going to waste my money. I'm going to put a few seeds out there. You're going to get a few peas, too.
Right.
But if you'll sow bountifully and have faith in God, I'm trusting you. Amen. I know you're able, God. You just have to keep preaching to yourself. And when you begin to preach to yourself, and let that now faith, Brother Herman. Let that now faith come in us. Right now, Sheila, we can't live off of last year's experience. We got to live right now. Brother Dot was talking about how things used to be in Victory Church, Holiness Church. I was able to sing in that church years ago. And Brother Herman, that church now has turned into a community center house and everything. Listen. The only difference between that and here is whether or not we worship God.
That's right. Exactly.
If we don't worship God and we don't have faith, listen, there's people out there watching, and some of you elders in the church. I ain't talking about you gray-headed folks like me, y'all. Well, some of y'all been serving God for a while. We got some young Christians coming in. They're watching you.
Yes, sir.
They're watching you. And they want to know how you are going to deal with what's going on in your life. They're going to watch you and see. When they see you worshiping God and you're in the valley, when they see you worshiping God when everything's going wrong, that's what they're going to do. But if they see you fold up your hand and give up, Brother Herman, that's what they're going to do. Come on. Brother Freddie, that little old fellow on the other side of Stephanie right there.
Yeah, come on.
Tiny. Old Tiny over there. Have you ever done something, Freddie? Maybe I'll ask Stephanie this. Stephanie, have you ever watched Brandon do something like his daddy? Freddie, have you ever been blessed to be doing something, just look over and watch him try to do the same thing he done?
like screwdrivers and wrenches, not knowing a thing what he's doing, but he's seen Daddy doing it, and he grabbed it. He's learning from watching you, Freddie.
That's right.
Exactly.
Tonight he came to an altar. Where did he learn that from?
That's right.
Learned watching you, Freddie.
That's right.
And Steph, he learned watching you. That's what we got to teach him, Sister Lord. You got a granddaughter right there. Amen. She needs God to move in her behalf. Amen. And she's going to learn about this car right here might be the very example that's going to show her if God can do that for Granny's car, surely he can do this for me. Amen. When we begin to trust God, and Josh, you're her uncle. You're her uncle. You're the one to be an example to her of what her daddy used to do and how her daddy used to be in church. And get her to pray, God, we got to get back in church. Because that's a talent. Your daddy's talented. But now, Faith, I want to ask you something. Are you going to go home and let the devil ride home with you?
Pray that again.
You're going to go home and let the devil ride home with you? And let him tell you how bad you got it. Or are you going to stop him at the door and say, devil, you're not leaving with me.
That's right.
If you're going to ride with somebody, it's going to be somebody else besides me. Amen? Because he's hitchhiking, Freddie. He's going to try to get a ride.
Somebody
will give one too, ain't it? Amen, but it ain't going to be with me.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you right now, y'all look at me and Sister Charlotte sometime, and y'all think we just got it made. Hey, I got battles too. I've got times when I've got to pray for the next meal to come in. Come on.
Amen.
I've got times I had to get down and pray for the next bill to be paid. Just like you.
Amen.
Just like you. I've got times when I lay down at night, just like my wife said, can't sleep. And Johnny, you know how it is when your wife is not feeling good. This thing. You know it bothers us. And knowing God, I can't do nothing but you can. And have to pray, Brother Freddie. I'm just like you, and I know what God can do. I know how God can bless and move, Brother Herman. But Sheila, I can't live off of what God did last week. This is a brand new week for me. I've got to start at my faith. And I've got to stand up like a lighthouse, Sister Lord, for these people watching my life. And every one of you here that are born again, God's watching your life. People that you don't even know is watching you. And I'm going to tell you something. Don't be like me. That time when I found my dearest friend, Dennis. When I allowed the enemy to pull me out of church. And he was like my brother. Me and him went together everywhere, Herman. I didn't know he was watching me. He never came to me and said, hey, if you stay in a little bit longer, I'll go to church with you. Never said it. But after I got out of church, Freddie, after I backslid on God, he went to my mama and said, if he'd have stayed in a little longer, I don't want that to ever be said of me again, Daddy. I've got too much to gain to lose. How many can really say right here tonight, this is what I'm fixing to ask you, if God done nothing else for us, Brother Thomas, nothing. We're blessed.
Amen.
If he done nothing else, Steph, nothing else, I still want to serve him.
Amen.
If he does nothing else for me, Sheila, I still want to go to heaven.
Amen.
I want to be there because he has been so faithful. That little song I sang, so just want to thank you, Lord, for every time you heard my prayer. Didn't say every time you answered it. Just the fact that he hears me, John. I just want to thank God for that. Well, somebody's watching y'all's life. And now's the time for that faith to rise up in you. And say, God, I'm going to be that lighthouse. You ever notice when the lighthouse is most needed? Johnny, ain't when the sun shines. It's in the dreadful nights of storm, hail, everything going wrong. That's when that Savior's looking for that light. Right where you're at right now seems like it's a storm. Seems like everything's breaking loose. Thomas, it's just like with you. You got four boys, you and Janet.
Them young boys are looking for a life. Thomas, you wouldn't brought her to this family just by happen chance. I know you've already been told this, but there was prayers in her. Prayers in her. That young girl lady right beside you prayed and sought God for a man just like you.
Amen.
It's not going to be easy. You're going to meet resistance. But if you'll hold strong, Thomas, when it's all said and done, you see four boys raised up to be godly men, you're going to thank God. Say, God, I thank you.
Amen.
And you may think you ain't got it in you, but I'm going to tell you right now, son, you do.
Amen.
You do. You do. Every one of you here, you got it in you.
Amen.
What God wants, if you'll just allow Him to use it in you.
Amen.
That's all it takes, Sheila. Is allow God to use what He put in. I told Brandon many times, I said, Brandon, I said, you need to be a leader, not a follower.
Amen.
He needs to get up and lead and begin to show them young men, hey, there's a better way than what y'all been doing. Follow me. And Brandon, lead them to Jesus. You can do that thing. But it's going to take somebody walking in now faith. Now faith. No, you can't see it. But it's there. It's there, and y'all's waiting for the grab. Musicians, make your way up here tonight. Church, Brother Herman preached last Sunday morning, last Sunday night, about things coming, and they're coming faster. Some of y'all weren't here Sunday morning when he made the mention of what they already legalized in Oregon. That's just the tip of the iceberg, John. They already legalized where a young person underage can go have a sex change and not even have to ask their parents. And the state will pay for it.
15-year-old can go have it done. And the federal organ will pay for it.
And children, let me ask you something. When they're getting bombarded daily in school, when they get bombarded daily watching television, because just about all your programs now have that on it. They have a subline under there of this going on. Of the males with the males and the females with the females. They have it, and they're laughing and joking about, Freddie, if we don't do something, if we don't do something, the devil's going to tell them. And listen, that's where it comes from. He tells them, you know you don't feel like a man. Oh, you know you ain't like a woman. And it always comes in, Johnny. The lighthouses. Where are those that stand up, Thomas, and tell what's right? I want to be that lighthouse. But it's going to take now faith. I want to stand up and preach it and teach it and live it. Let's stand all over the building. D chord. D. I want you to ask yourself a question here tonight. And I want you to be truthful just to you. Lord, am I doing all that I can do for you? The Holy Ghost said that my people are spending too much time away from you. Is that you? Are you tied up in all other kind of things except what matters about the Lord? Is that you? There's a job to be done here in McGarville, Alabama, and the surrounding counties. We've got to win the lost. Johnny, we got to win them. It's going to take every one of us, Sister Jewel, every single one of us doing our part. But if everyone here will do their part and begin to bring in the souls, on that day, Josh, we can say, hallelujah, we obeyed God and we've seen souls saved. Father, I've done all that I know to do. I preach that what you gave me to preach. And Lord, I ask God that you'll touch the hearts of those that are here. And God, you will deal with us again about working in the field for you, Lord. These altars are open right now. If you want to make that commitment to God, then just say, Lord, here I am. Wherever and however you want to use me, whenever you want to use me, here I am. make that walk. And Brother Johnny said, these altars are for us. They're for us to come and offer the sacrifice of praise unto the Lord. Come on, these altars open right now. Jesus, tonight.
but your Lord.
Sunday, 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 I Sunday each Sunday.
takes a desert to get a hold on me. But your love is so much stronger. Whatever's troubling me, but sometimes it takes a mountain for me to trust you completely. Somebody here tonight, don't let that mountain discourage you. Troubled around you. No, he's there walking on the waves. His word said he made a highway and a river to run in the desert. Listen what he said. But your love is so much stronger than whatever's troubling me. Takes a mountain for me to trust you and me.
My, what a powerful service. The preacher said, the Holy Ghost has said it, time to get short. Time's getting short. Okay. Sister Linda, come on up. Let's pray for Sister Johnson down there in the Wilmington area. She has a problem with diabetes, right?
Yeah.
In her foot. And we're going to believe right now for the healing virtue that God's going to touch her. Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, touch Sister Johnson right now. God, heal those feet right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, her faithfulness before you, God. Lord, has come up with more, I know. God, their walk with you, God, has been straightforward, God. And God, they need healing right now in their bodies, God. They need strength in their bodies. God, this valley they're going through, Lord, is uncharted ground to them. And God, but you're going to be there with them, God. You're going to strengthen them. God, let more truth be revealed to them, God. Oh, in the baptism of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, I know you can do it at home, God. Don't have to be in church, God. Lord, let them receive you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God, praise God. Thank you, brothers. Appreciate
you. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Brother Freddie, you walk with me. Well, you're on day then.
That'd be up.
You going to do Bible study with us tonight?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
All right. And Brother Herman M. had made mention last Monday when we was out on the slab praying that we may change it to Tuesday night. I think Sister Lois and them, y'all going down and helping Brandon and them on Monday nights or something other down there?
Well, it was, I won't be tomorrow night. I'll be in Mobile tomorrow.
Right. So y'all want to change it to Tuesday night or what do y'all want to do?
He's probably
help
you too, didn't
you? So, we'll do it on Tuesday night instead of Monday night. We'll meet down here at 6 o'clock like we've been doing. And some may look at this and say, oh, ain't nothing happened. Look around you.
Yes,
y'all been hearing all them whining babies?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Terry got a good example of one tonight. Amen. But you know what? That's part of growing church.
Yes,
that's part of it right there and everything. Thank God to have these young boys here tonight. Thank God to have Megan come down to honey. Don't let that be the end of it. That's the beginning.
Amen.
Grow stronger in the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. I don't think there's any other announcement I need to make. I'm good and forgetful, so I don't mind y'all reminding me. If everybody's mind's clear, is there anything else we need to make mention of? They all laughing. I don't know what for.
I just said I ain't too good at it.
Let's all stand. Everybody's mind's clear. Brother Freddie, how about dismissing us in prayer?
Oh, Father, we thank you once again for being able to put your eyes on certain people. Yeah. Thanks for the message and the movement we felt from you tonight.
Yes.
Lord God, thank you for the Holy Ghost. Lord, we ask that you be with each and every one of us. Bring us back to the desire and the time. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.